Hey, up. You're up early.
Things to do, my son. Here, don't say I never give you anything.
Thanking you. So, what's with a good mood?
What? Oh, I'm always in a good mood, boy.
All right.
So, come on, what is it?
Well, come on, then.
Let's just say there's been an interesting development.
Oh, what, like you getting your job back at the garage?
Maybe.
What, are you serious? What, you actually took my advice and I came for your job back?
I did a lot better than that.
Oh, what do you mean?
I told Kane that if he doesn't sign the garage over to me by 12 today, that I'll grass Debbie up for the attack.
You did what?
Perhaps that's all.
Ross, please tell me you're joking.
Fine, I'll get it myself.
But why are you threatening to come clean now? What, have you had enough of protecting Debbie or something?
Something like that.
But what about the shooting? Look, Kane could tell the police everything.
Yeah, but Debbie won't let him do that. It's fine, mate.
Right, well, I hope you know what you're doing, because you can't just threaten Kane like that.
Why? I'm not scared of Kane.
Then you're losing your marbles, pal.
Pete, they owe me. Even then, it's still not enough.
Yeah, I know they do. But Kane isn't going to see it that way, is he?
He won't let anything happen to Debbie.
Oh, you're right. But when it comes to it, I don't think you'd see her in jail. Especially with Sarah being ill.
Yeah, well, with what Kane's done, that family deserve bringing down a peg or two.
Well, what's he done now?
Hi.
Hi.
It's nice to see you're not avoiding this place.
Well, there's no reason to. You've both decided to move on, haven't you?
Yeah.
Defo.
Well, I'm glad you popped in. And I'm sorry for being a numpty.
Not the word I'd use, but still.
Dad.
Well, it's good we can be civil. And maybe even friends at some point.
Maybe.
Looks like you're out of sausages. Do you have any more in the barrel?
Yes. I'll just nip up. We'll be a sec.
I hope that's not what I think it is.
Think what is?
That look, I've seen it before.
Oh, don't be daft.
I thought you made your mind up about him, not to go back there again after the way he's treated you.
Yeah, I have. I won't, I'm not. Just drop it, okay?
Good. Because I don't want to see you getting hurt again.
Thanks, Dad. But honestly, we've got nothing to worry about.
Morning, guys.
Hey, if it isn't the delightful Jessie.
Morning.
Usual?
Yes, please.
Take a seat, I'll bring it over.
Oh, I can't stick around, so I'll just have a takeout, please, Rodney.
All right, coming right up. You're looking very smart today. You off somewhere nice?
I have a job interview. Well, technically it's round two.
Ah, I didn't know you were moving on from Connellton Primary.
Depends how it goes, really.
Oh, fingers crossed for you.
Thank you.
Sorry, what's all this?
Oh, I'm interviewing for the head teacher role at Hotham Academy. Today should be the decider.
Oh, wow, that's great. That's great. Mm. And is it a temporary thing or permanent?
No, permanent. Head teacher left suddenly. Oh, a big secret as to why, but they need a replacement. Hopefully it should be me.
Well, that's great. That's really great.
Well, you know, they might not even offer it to me, so just see how it goes.
In life, I've always found it's best to keep your options open.
Cheers, Rodney.
Thank you.
So, when will you find out?
Not quite sure, to be honest. But don't worry, you'll be the first to know. Anyway, I'd better go there. Don't want to be late.
Good luck.
Ah, hi, Rona. Oh.
Why is she going to in such a hurry?
Had an interview for a new head teacher job.
What, an academy? Yeah. Do you think maybe we should talk her out of it?
Why would we do that?
Why? Well, because Leo's doing so well, you know, somebody new comes in, the old school could change.
Hey.
Got a cup of tea?
No, I'm fine, cheers.
Oh, well, Sarah will be pleased you're here. She's sulking in her bedroom.
No, no, just leave her be.
What's going on?
Simon turned up yesterday.
What? Why? What did he want?
He wanted to make it clear for us to leave him alone.
Well, what happened?
Nothing. We just had a civil chat.
Well, why didn't you just tell me that he was here?
Well, why? What would you have done about it? You've got enough on your plate at the moment. Look, the important thing is you can forget him now. He won't be coming back. But there was something else.
What?
Ross saw him. And now he's threatening to go to the police about you if I don't give him the garage.
How many more times? There wasn't a look. I was just looking in his direction. You're reading too much into this, Dad.
He's just worried you might go back to David.
Oh, will you stop going on? Look, that thing that happened was a one-off and it won't be happening again.
Take my advice. At your age, you'll have more fun playing the field.
Trouble is, you're still playing it.
I think you'll find that I'm in a very satisfying relationship.
Poor Misty.
Well, I'm glad you decided to make a clean break.
Same here. You'd never be able to trust him.
You need to be practical now. Start thinking about your future.
And if you do get a divorce, he was the one who cheated, so you ought to be entitled to half the shop.
I don't think it works like that.
I'm not ready to think about any of that stuff yet.
Oh, hang on. You're not still hoping for a reconciliation, are you?
Of course not.
This is all my fault.
You never meant for any of this to happen. All you wanted was Joe beating up. It was that idiot Simon who took it into his own hands and decided to throw the acid.
Yeah, I know that.
You can't keep torturing yourself.
He's blackmailing you when you should be me. Please tell me that you are not considering that offer. You know what? I think it's just time that I went to the police and just told the truth.
No. If Ross tries it on, then we tell him about him shooting you.
No, we don't. Have you got any idea how many times I've wanted to go to that police station and confess? Then all of this would just be over.
They'll put you away for years.
Well, maybe that's what I deserve.
And what about Jack and Sarah? They need you. You've got to forget about this.
I'm never going to forgive myself for what happened to him.
Listen to me. You've got to move on.
What's this? Oh, it's nothing. It's just rubbish.
Where did you get it?
I can't remember.
This shows that my family have been searching. You said they didn't care.
They don't. I bet they just printed these to make other people think they do. You told me Kerry used to lie to con people.
But why did you lie to me?
For your own good. After all the awful things they did. This doesn't mean anything. Just forget you ever saw it.
You're not seriously considering handing over the garage. It's your business. And what if he wants more?
It won't come to that.
How do you know?
I'm not going to give him the garage.
OK, then, so what are you planning? I'm telling you now, it better not be anything stupid, because we're in enough trouble as it is.
Don't worry. I know what I'm doing.
Oh, hey.
Sorry, I got your message, but I didn't get a chance to call you back. It's been a crazy morning. Just thought I'd pop by, see if you weren't busy.
Well, as you can see, we're very quiet. You okay?
Doesn't matter.
Of course it does. Go on, spill. Did us good yesterday to offload.
Liam and I had another blazing row, and he walked out last night. Haven't seen or heard from him since.
Ah. Well, I'm sure he'll call.
Doubt it. Anyway, enough about me and my tragic relationship. How's things going with you and Tracy?
I think the best I can hope for is that we'll be friends.
Do you know what? I think we could both do with a drink. How about it?
No, I shouldn't, but I'm easily swayed, so yes. What are you doing? No, put your money away.
A
toast to losers.
To losers.
Tracy doesn't see how great you are, and it's her loss.
Well, it's nice to see that you're on time for once. So, it's midday. Time to hand this place over, pal.
You seem to be forgetting our arrangement. You keep quiet about Debbie and we keep quiet about you shooting her. Now, you break your word on that. Why should I give you anything?
Because things have changed. You knew where Simon was and you didn't say anything.
You would have made things worse.
Not for me, I wouldn't have. I bet you know where he is now.
No, I don't.
Liar. And that's why you owe me. So come on, let's get on with it. And the keys over, or shall I take a little trip to the police station?
I'm not going to give you this garage. You'll run this place into the ground. So? Why don't we run it together?
What, are you being serious?
No, you're a good mechanic. And you're right, yeah. We do owe you. So I'm going to give you 40%. Take it or leave it.
Maybe I should go home. No, no, no. Please don't go. I know I should have shown you the leaflet, but I was just trying to protect you. If my family have been searching for me, then they must be worried. They don't care, Amelia. They don't deserve you. And that leaflet was just for show. I really am sorry for keeping it from you. Your family's the ones who've lied. I'm just worried about what they'd do if you went back. I thought we'd been having fun. We have. And we'll have lots more when that money comes through. So we good? Yeah, we're good.
How do I know this is on a level?
Because it'll be ordered above board.
I struggle to trust anyone called Dingle.
Well, it's either that or you end up in prison yourself. At least this way, something good comes out of all of this.
60-40. That's the best you can do.
It's the only offer I'm going to make.
50-50. I'm not going to forgive you for what you did.
So do we have a deal?
Yeah.
Good. You threaten us again. I won't be so nice next time.
I had no idea Liam was that boring.
David, be a mate and break this down for me, will you? Mm-hmm. Yeah. We've run out of change in the cafe.
You busy?
Well, it seems a lot busier than you, although maybe you prefer it that way.
Another irritating thing that Liam does. Every morning, he throws open the curtains and he says, another day, another dollar. And he does this silly laugh.
Have you not told him it irritates you?
Try. But he thinks it's hilarious. What about Tracy?
Well, I used to hate it when she used to offer to tidy up because she used to get all my stuff and shove it out of sight. Couldn't find my tanning mitt for weeks.
Well, you won't have to put up with that anymore.
No.
I've really enjoyed our chat.
Me too. You have a way of cheering me up.
Yeah, likewise.
What? So, this is where you've been hiding.
What are you doing here?
I was out on a call. Don't need to ask what you've been up to.
It was all my fault.
Hey, you don't need to apologise, David. He was the one that walked out on me.
And then I realised I'd overreacted. I wanted to sort this out. But you obviously don't. Back to your old tricks, I see.
You really shouldn't blame Maya.
I find that very hard to believe.
Look, we were just having a drink, we were having a chat. We didn't do
it. Do you really expect me to believe that? You might as well just forget all the excuses and admit. You've been cheating with my wife.
Look, you've been great giving me time off, but I think it's about time I got back to work.
Look, you do whatever you need to. Why don't you pop over this afternoon? Could do with a hand.
Thanks, Kay.
Oh, and, Ross is back.
I look forward to that. Hey.
Hey. Any news on Amelia?
Nah. Nothing.
Well, they'll find her. Can't wait any longer. I need to know what happened with Ross.
We, settled on a partnership.
So I've cost you half the garage?
60-40 in my favour.
I can't believe you've had to do this.
It was the right thing to do. Plus, I need another good mechanic.
Thanks. Can't have been easy.
It's the end of an era then, I guess.
Yeah. A small price to pay for drawing a line under everything. Plus, it means you get your life back.
Mm. If you don't come back for more, that is.
He won't. Look, Ross got a share because he was right, we owed him.
You mean I owed him?
Well, we both did. You need to focus on your two kids now. It's over.
Oh, well, you're right.
Good. Right. I'm going to let you make me a cuppa. Come off.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm just not sure I'm doing the right thing.
I knew there was something earlier. I thought you decided it was over, that going back to David was a mistake.
Yeah, I did. I keep changing my mind. And then seeing him earlier, what shall I do?
Look, there's no rush to decide anything. Eventually, you'll figure out what you want.
I still love him.
You ought to be talking to David about this.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
See you here.
So you haven't heard any news about Jessie's interview, then?
No. Bet they offer her the job, though.
I hope not. For April and Leo's sake.
You're not thinking of those two. You're just worried you'll miss seeing Jessie at the school gate every day. Yes.
Start back at the garage later, so I'll be back in the funds again soon.
Well, it's a distraction, if nothing else.
What do you want?
Look, I know how you feel about me, but I need to borrow some money.
Are you for real?
Dan.
Look, I can't get the ransom together.
Oh, here we go.
I'm doing this for Amelia.
Whatever.
I'm desperate.
Just go, Daz. No one wants you round here.
Why wouldn't you believe me, Benith? Hey, I had nothing to do with Amelia going missing. Someone is trying to frame me. Time's running out. Oh. Great. Right. Well, I'll prove it to you. I'll find out who's doing this. And I'll bring Amelia home.
You really shouldn't be angry with me. I said it was my fault. I misread the signals. I went in for a kiss.
Graham, don't! Please, just leave him alone.
Look, I know you're angry. But the only reason I went in for a kiss was because I thought me and my wife were going to get back together. And that's not what she wanted. So
what's that got to do with anything?
Because I'm in a bad place. And I'm feeling unwanted. And Maya's been so nice. And we had a drink.
I've heard enough. A tacky affair with a local shopkeeper. Is that the best you can do?
Well, we're annoyed about it too, but...
Let's just go.
How long's this been going on for?
How are you going to answer him, David?
Dress.
You kissed her?
No,
I don't know why I'm surprised. Do you know what? You're welcome to him. But please, don't start thinking he cares, because he was all over me just a few days ago. In fact, his idea of being faithful is only having one woman in his bed at a time. I'm sure he'd make an exception there, given half the chance.
I've had enough humiliation for one day. We'll continue this at home.
Fine. Bye.
I'm sorry you're to hear that.
I'm not. Because do you know what? You've done me a favour. As you stupid ring back, David. I want a divorce. We're finished.
Yeah, I've got it. Where do you want to meet?
Got something for me.
What? Who are you?
All I know is that you've got to give me something and I've got to tell you an address. So where is it? Where is it? Show me!
Tell me the address first.
What's that?
Nothing. Hey! Come here!
I was thinking about calling Joe and asking him round for tea. Sarah. Sorry, I wasn't concentrating. I was just reading some messages from normal people who go out and do things. Something about Joe. Yeah, I was thinking about asking him round for tea. You know, like you said the other day? Yeah, why not? Have a social life, be my guest. Right, okay, is this about the disco? It's all everyone's going on about. I'm just sick of not being allowed to do things. Sarah, you know why? Because everyone's going to be spreading the germs. Mum, Safi's made a meme of me with a goldfish bowl around my head. Oh, has she? Well, maybe I'll go round to Safi's house and pay a bit of attention to her little head. Don't you dare. Listen, Sarah, I don't want to fight with you. Then don't. Are you waiting for me to tell you to phone Joe? You don't need my permission. Yes, I know I don't. Thank you. I would rather you were happy with it, that's all. It's only tea that we're talking about, but, you know, if he's coming round, then I want you to be nice to him. How about let me go to the school disco and I'll sing him a song? I'm not going to spoil it. Seriously, just phone him. Mum, I'm not the fun wreck around here.
Says here you should try to agree your reasons for divorce with your ex-partner. Find out more about the 5 facts you should use, known as grounds for divorce. Well, I am looking for a hopeless man-child with no control over himself, but...
Oh, Tracy, what happened?
I went to see him to talk about things and there they were. David and Maya and Liam, Dr. Kavanagh, having a giant shouting match in the shop. Mainly Liam shouting and David just whinging and denying, really. Turns out Liam don't appreciate his wife snogging the local grocer. No. Yeah, remember how you said eventually I would know what I want? Like, I just had to wait and things would click into place. I think that little scene was it clicking. Because I don't need this. I don't need to be made to feel bad about myself over and over and over again. So I gave him his ring back.
and told him I wanted a divorce.
Oh, come here. Oh.
I wish Jake could answer his texts.
Trouble?
Not yet. But when he finds out...
Try to cop a feel of his teacher.
That is not what happened.
Don't let her wind you up. Have you thought of going to see Liam?
So that's a good idea.
David, have you got a minute?
I don't know. Depends whether it's going to end with your husband trying to punch me.
He was never going to punch you. Anyway, we're past that now.
There we go. Happy ever after.
No. Not really happy ever after. It's over with us. We're finished.
You okay? Have you been running?
I got all the way to the shop and guess what? Forgot my purse, so I ran back.
No way. Well, everything's measured out and ready.
I'm tired now. Maybe we'll make do.
You can't make a cake without eggs.
Don't make me go out again. Please. Can't I make something else? Just give me a moment to think. How about a Coke? It's not cold, but there's some ice cream here, I think. An ice cream float. Which is ice cream floating in Coke. Kind of obvious, really. What delicious. Amelia, what do you reckon? Amelia?
Just in the middle. All right. In the middle.
Right.
Dan, in the middle.
Right.
What? Gonna need changing, innit?
You sure you're feeling up to this, Dan?
Bill's not gonna pay himself.
Oh, still here. Look, if you've got a problem, take it up with your dad. I'm not arguing with you.
I spoke to my dad. I haven't got a problem, I'm pleased.
A few jacks and some spanners. Not much of a trade for my life, is it?
Well, I hope it makes you happy. Honestly, I do.
Dan, come out here, mate. Hold this.
So, is this really how it's going to be? You rubbing my sister's face in it?
What? Look, there's nothing going on there.
I've just seen her.
She came to apologise.
For what? Forcing you to kiss her?
That never happened, right?
Oh, and that's what she was apologising for.
Do you know what? What is the point? Tracy's made her mind up. She wants a divorce. What? She came here and pretty much demanded it.
No, she came to talk to you, to see if there was any hope. And then she saw her, that, you know, your Barney in the shop and realised there wasn't.
Why are you joking?
No, there's nothing funny about it.
Well, where is she?
She's gone into town.
Give us your phone.
Why?
Because she won't answer it if she knows it's me.
Well, don't do this over the phone. I'll buzz you when she's back, if you like. Go and see her, but don't expect miracles.
Amelia! Amelia, what are you doing?
You caught me.
I thought we'd agreed. It's too dangerous to go out at the moment.
I just got back and let me do this.
The bad people, Amelia. He's done bad things.
Who has?
Daz. He's done bad, terrible stuff.
My uncle Daz.
Yes, your uncle Daz. He's ruined my life and given half the chance he'll ruin yours. So don't do this, Amelia, please.
I was getting eggs.
Eggs? Right. You should have said. Scared the life out of me. Suddenly you weren't there.
What has Daz done?
Beth, what has he done?
Oh, don't cry.
She probably hated her, won't she? Or not. All I can do is cross my fingers.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Marlon.
What?
This is her career. She deserves to be happy and fulfilled.
Yes, I want her to be happy and fulfilled at the primary school, giving Leo all the support he needs.
You're still going to see her around? It's not like she's just going to vanish. He has developed a terrible teacher fetish.
Oh,
ever since he had to sit on a teeny tiny chair and get told off by Jessie.
Right, you're making it sound dirty now.
He's been playing the long game.
Not through choice.
But now he's worried that if she leaves Connaughton Primary, then he will lose his excuse to keep chipping away at her defences.
Why don't you just ask her out? Yes, I hadn't thought of that.
Here she is.
So, what are you having?
Oh, now, shall I just have an orange juice, throw a caution to the wind and add a splash of lemonade in there as well?
You celebrating?
Celebrating with an orange juice? How sad do you think I am?
Oh, not sad at all. In fact, talking aside, Bob was just saying how sad his kids are going to be to leave the primary school because...
Hey?
Really?
Oh, yeah. They're gutted. They're gutted, yeah.
It's not what Cathy said to Mr. Taylor.
Awkward.
What did Cathy say to
him? I'm really going to miss the place. To be fair, that's for sure. Oh, sorry. Didn't I say? I've been offered the job.
Oh, well done. You sure you got the right person? Dad wouldn't do anything like that. He killed my dad. And he lied. And he's dangerous. And he doesn't care about anybody except himself. Why would I lie to you? You're my only friend.
Right,
can we forget about the eggs? We'll do it another time. I just want to go home now. Right, come on, race you home. Right, Amelia, you've got to listen to what I'm saying to you. You've got to forget about him and you've got to come with me, okay? Right, come on.
Thank God. My little one.
You hurt?
No.
Why?
Hey! What are you thinking?
We're connected, me and you.
What?
No. Please, I just want to go home.
No, come here. Amelia!
And what's the worst that can happen? She won't have eaten him.
Trust me, that is not the worst thing that could be happening.
Oh, that's a bit of an escalation. Anyway, you heard him. He said he won't go there again.
David is always open to suggestion.
You mean he's a bloke?
I just mean...
Sex, Eric. You can say it. It is 2018.
He has a tendency to do what other people want him to do because he doesn't like to hurt their feelings.
Try telling Tracy that. Look, he probably just wants a bit of time on his own. Come on, stop worrying. Let's have another drink.
Marking.
Yeah, head teachers don't mark. We just spend our lives ticking boxes.
I'm sorry. Being selfish. I'm pleased for you. Of course I am. I just got in a panic, that's all. I worry about change, where Leo's concerned. In fact, it's not just Leo.
Marlon, do you want my money or not?
Sorry.
So?
I couldn't ask her out as well as apologise. One awkward conversation at a time is hard enough for me. I can't do two. You've got to separate your awkward conversations.
He has got a point, to be fair.
Hold on.
Hang on.
Oh, for Pete's sake.
Hello again.
Hi. There was something else. You know, I bloodied your nose that time and then asked you out and you said no.
Yeah, what was I thinking?
Do I get another chance?
What, to break my nose?
We got off to the wrong start. I know that. And believe me, every single time I look at you, I hate myself for messing up. And do you know what? I understand that you're unsure about the whole dating thing. I get that because I get stressed out and then I clown about and I'm sorry for being pushy, but Jessie, I like you too much just to give up. So can we start again, please? Just two unsure, stressed out people having a bite to eat. That's all.
Okay.
Sarah, put that away now, please. This is my only way of communicating with the outside world.
Things aren't that bad, are they?
Oh, at first I wasn't even allowed to do this. She thought that germs could crawl down the phone and leap out the speaker.
Sarah, I said put it away.
See? No, it's rude to have your phone at the table. What are you laughing at?
Nothing. You're just so similar.
We are not.
I'm the evil mother that won't let Cinderella go to the ball.
It's a school disco, that's all.
You sure she can't?
You ever been to these things? 20 minutes in and the room's like a sweat pit of teenage bacteria.
Nice. And you really want to go?
Oh, yeah, I'm weird like that. Dancing and music and, you know, talking to people my own age.
School discos are always rubbish.
And who invited you? Anyway, it's better than being sat round here watching some dinosaur clump around with antibacterial spray.
Right, it's not funny now.
How about this? Why don't we have a party at Home Farm instead? Obviously not a big one. Coughers and sneezes turned away at the door. Just Sarah and a friend of your choosing.
Will there be pasta parcel?
If you like.
She is teasing you.
I know. There'll be food and music and it'll be fun, I promise. It won't be an embarrassment and we don't even have to call it a party. Just something to get you out of the house.
If you don't mind.
I don't mind if Joe doesn't.
Thanks.
Keys. End of the perfect day.
Amelia.
Amelia!
Amelia!
I'm sorry.
You okay? Did he hurt you?
Come here, Angel. Come here. Get away from her.
When I brought her back. Amelia, tell her.
You murder.
Stay away!
Tress, I don't want this. I don't want to get divorced. It's just one stupid misunderstanding.
Oh, whatever. It's not, though, is it? It's misunderstanding after lie, after suspicion.
There's nothing going on between me and Maya.
David, it doesn't matter.
Of course it does.
Right, try and understand what I saw, yeah, when I came into the shop. It was the closest I have got to some perspective in a very long time. Your chaotic, clumsy life. The shouting, you all red-faced and indignant because of course it's not your fault, is it? I mean, these things just happen to you again and again and again.
Okay, but why? Why now? Why now when I haven't even done anything?
Oh. Oh, you mean, why not earlier? When I found out you'd slept with Layla? David, I am not divorcing you because of what you've done. I'm divorcing you because of who you are. And how you make me feel.
What? I'll be different, I'll change.
Let's be real, yeah? If Maya had a come round, said the right things, looked weak, made you feel sorry for her, maybe cried, because we both know what a sucker you are for a weepy, pretty lady, you'd have gone to bed with her. You'd have done it. A bit because you fancy her. And a bit just to be light.
No, I
think you should go, David. Because we
are so over.
What did you call her? The young woman? If she didn't give you a name, you must have called her something.
Think back.
Look, she was like this all the way home. I couldn't get a word out of her.
Mr. Spencer, perhaps if you gave Amelia some space, she might find it easier to talk.
Yeah, but I saw her. You've not even asked me for a description yet.
I'm telling you to be quiet, Mr. Spencer.
Yeah. Shut up or get lost, Oz.
That goes for everyone. I need some peace to ask Amelia a few more questions. Mr. Spencer said that he saw you arguing with her. What were you arguing about?
Nothing.
Then what was she saying?
She knew Daz.
The girl said that she knew your uncle?
Daz?
Well, yes, she said it. But I don't know what she was on about, I swear.
You're a liar.
Looks like your little kidnapper friends landed you right in it. No wonder Amelia was quiet. Probably scared witless of you.
That's enough from you as well.
How could you do this?
I didn't do anything. I haven't got a clue who she was.
But she knows you.
She said something weird about us being connected. I've never seen her before in my life. Then she just ran off.
Amelia, did you ever see the girl and your uncle together? It's very important. Amelia, did this man, your Uncle Daz, did he take you?
Hey, I ain't gone. Amelia!
Yeah.
Mr. Spencer, I'm arresting you on suspicion of abduction. You do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defence if you do not mention when questioned something which you later rely on in court. Anything you do say may be given in evidence.
I didn't do it. Amelia!
Emmerdale continues Wednesday night at 7 here on ITV. Next tonight, the Websters get some devastating news in Coronation Street. Then at 9, Davina and Nikki catch up with more reunited relatives in Long Lost Family. What happened next?